Let's start off by looking at a linear problem. You recall that a linear problem is something where we can fit a line to separate, say, the spam from the not spam, depending on a couple of input variables. Here we've got two input variables, x1 and x2. These are input features. And we've got a linear model here of w1 x1, w2 x2, and a bias term. Now this is easy to fit, right? However, what if our model needed to model something more complicated? In particular, what if our data, in fact, looks more like this? In this world, there's really no way for us to fit a simple linear model that's going to get anything more than about 50% accuracy. What can we do? Well, one clever idea is that we could define an additional feature. We're going to call this a synthetic feature, or a feature cross. We're going to do it like this. We're going to call it x3. We're going to define x3 as the product of x1 and x2. Now, can I use x3 in my linear model? Yes, indeed, I can. I'm going to go ahead and add a coefficient, w3, for x3. And you'll notice that the product of x1 and x2 is always positive if they're both positive, or if x1 and x2 are both negative. So I get this very nice ability to pull out my blue dots if the product of x1 and x2 is positive. Similarly, we'll always have a negative if either one of these coordinates is negative. So this allows us to learn a non-linearity within a linear model using a simple synthetic feature that's called a cross product. So the general name of this process of creating synthetic features as products of other features, we call feature crosses, feature cross products. We can think of these as maybe templates of the form sort of A cross B. They could be complex, A cross B cross C cross D. And when A and B are Boolean features, things that we might get from a one-hot encoding, like various strings or bins, the resulting crosses might be quite sparse. That one-hot encoding may have an awful lot of zeros in it. Let's think of some additional examples here of where feature crosses might be useful. So for predicting housing prices in California, we might want to say cross latitude or bind latitude with the number of bedrooms. And this would allow us to learn that maybe having 3 bedrooms in San Francisco is a very different thing from having 3 bedrooms in Sacramento. You could also think about a tic-tac-toe predictor. And you might think of the cross products that you would be able to use there by crossing the various coordinates in the tic-tac-toe grid. Because obviously an X or an O in any particular segment of that tic-tac-toe grid by itself isn't very interesting, but to be able to say your left corner, center, right bottom altogether is a very different thing. So why would we want feature crosses? Well, the main thing is that this allows us to incorporate nonlinear learning into a linear learner. Now, linear learners are very interesting to us because they scale very naturally to massive scale data sets. In fact, for many years, linear learners were the only method that we really had that would scale to billions or hundreds of billion sized data sets. Now, we also have deep neural networks that can scale well. So that's another option that we'll look at later on in this class. Finally, there's been some interesting research showing that combining the effects of linear learning through feature cross products and deep networks can be extremely powerful for modeling.